get this set up. So we got two things here. We got an electrical connector, which has a switch on it for some reason. I don't know how that would have worked, but, and hoses with nothing on them. So there's everything we need. That ground is B. Look at that. Goes like that, and you can see him in that hole right there. Take your crimper. Go right here. So we're gonna go B and D according to our diagram. Up all the way, but such a difference. All right, I'll see if it works. Use it for like a tractor. I don't right, well, I feel that does a pretty good demonstration of what this thing does. You know, it took a little bit to get used to it, but it does do a nice job dragging around, you know, long trees in tight areas. I do think this would be better on the back of a tractor. You know, one slightly frustrating thing with it is that you can't do any earthwork with it. You know, all you can do is kind of move around things that you can grab. And as far as like a root grapple or something that I'm used to using, with this thing, I can push a tree over, rip the stump out of the ground, fill the hole back in, carry the stump to the burn pile, gather up piles of brush, carry all the logs. Really, that's hard to beat. Honestly, that other thing, I think that would be better on the back of a tractor for like strategically grabbing logs out of the woods for logging operations, not really land clearing. Attachment is neat, but you know, for what I'm doing right now, clearing land, this thing, that's the way to go. I almost kind of want to grab like a category 2 tractor and try this on the back. I think that'd probably be pretty nice for just pulling logs long distances through technical areas. But right now, let's get some grass seed down and keep running that one. All right, guys, what do you think?